Hi students, and welcome back to bankexamstudy.com. And today I am going to tell you about how to start your preparations for IBPS PO pre-exam. So let's start with the exam pattern. So in IBPS PO pre-exam, there are three sections. The first one is English section. There are 30 questions, each having one mark. The next one is quantitative aptitude. 35 questions, each having one mark, 35 marks to quantitative aptitude section and 35 marks to reasoning ability section. Three section, 1 hour is allotted to the whole exam. There is no sectional timing at all. So let's start with the quantitative aptitude section. How you should start your preparations for quantitative aptitude section. So first of all, let me tell you the trending topics. In last few exams, I have seen few topics, a pattern of topics that we have seen in quantitative aptitude section. So it is, in the 35 questions, you will see two data interpretation sets, 5 marks each. Most of the times it is double diagram. Once it will be double diagram, there will be a pie chart and then there will be a histogram or a table. That's the most common data interpretation part. The second one will be the data analysis. That is also very important. And the third common type of data interpretation questions is the data analysis. So you're going to find these three type of data interpretation sets in your exam. So do not expect those simple pie charts and those simple histograms with 3-4 statements along with them that you were seeing in those 2010 or 2009 exams. The difficulty level has been changed, so prepare yourself accordingly. So I have made 3 workbooks for data interpretation section. I will provide the links to those workbooks, those free workbooks, in the description. Download those ebooks and prepare yourself. Just practice all the ebooks, workbooks actually. Practice all these workbooks. There are at least 250, 300 sets for the data interpretation, all based on the latest trends. So practice all these data interpretation sets, that these 3 ebooks will be enough for you. The second part, the arithmetic. So there are around 9 to 10 chapters in arithmetic. The first one is time and work, then there is time and distance, simple and compound interest, problems based on ages. Problem based on ages is a part of reasoning as well as it's a part of quantitative aptitude. Then there is simple and compound interest, profit and loss, averages, ratio and proportions, HCF, LCM, number system. So these are all part of arithmetic. You will find 8 to 12 questions from arithmetic. One question each from, time and work, time and distance, from all this chapter, one or two questions each from that. Maybe you will find one or two questions from simplification, but I don't expect those simplification questions. Then there will be algebra. They cannot be algebra of 2 or 3 marks. Simple questions from algebra, don't go into that differentiation, integration. That is a part of SSC syllabus. No need to go that deep into that algebra part. Then probability, permutation and combination. Again, it's 1 or 2 marks thing. Don't go that deep. Just learn the basics about probability, learn the basics about permutation and combination. I'll make a video about this specific topic within next 1 week. So stay updated on bankexamstudy.com. Subscribe our channel. So that's all about quantitative aptitude section. The good things about the good books that are available that I'm going to discuss. Before doing that, I want to say that don't follow R.S. Agarwal. Don't follow that M. Tyra book on Quicker Maths. These are not good books for you, and these are outdated books. If you are doing so, you are not. It is very difficult to crack these exams if you are following those two books. Don't follow those two books at all. There are many other good books available in the market. The book by Arun Sharma, that's good. Nishit Sinha, but that is a bit of a higher level. You can use that book for mains exam. And then there is a book by Sarvesh Kumar Verma. That is also a good book. You can read my book. That is also available. Data interpretation part is available for free. Quantitative Aptitude Made Easy. That is my book. You can also follow that book also. But there are lots of good books available in the market. That Sarvesh Kumar Verma, that is also a great book. I think the name of the book is Quantum Cat. Great book. I don't, you know, these people haven't paid me a single penny for recommending these books, but I am doing that to help you out. Many of the people who are recommending R.S. Agarwal or M. Tyra, they are trying to make money by putting their affiliate links in the descriptions. People do that. Actually, Amazon and Flipkart, these people pay 10% of the sale value to the affiliates. Affiliate like those YouTubers or, you know, people like on small sites. They sell Amazon's product on their site. So they try to sell R.S. Agarwal's book because everybody is buying that book quickly. This is one of the bestseller book. So whenever you go to Amazon.com, you find this is a bestseller book. Yeah, you just click the buy button instantly. But in case of these Sarvesh Kumar Verma, these kind of books, you are not going to click that buy now quickly. So it impacts their, you know, earnings. So they try to sell R.S. Agarwal because it is easy to sell. So I highly recommend you not to follow that R.S. Agarwal and Tyra books. So I have already explained you what to follow, what not to follow. Important things. Learn all the tables. That is very important. From up to, I think you should learn about table of 35. That is more than enough. If you can read till 40, that is very good. It is very easy. I think table up to 40, it's easy. But minimum table up to 30. You should just learn those tables. Then squares up to 50, even if you can go up to 100. Square of 94, what is the square of 9? You should know what is the square of 94, 95. You should learn those squares. Then cubes, you should learn the cubes up to 20, like learn the cubes up to that part. Then learn the factors. Learn, you know, what is the value of 1 over 12? What is the value of 1 over 10? 1 over 10 is it is 10%. What is the value of 1 over 5? You should know what the value of 1 over 5 is 20%. Value of 1 over 4 is 25%. You should know. Value of 1 over 3 is 33.33%. You should know that. So that is the what I have to explain about the quantitative aptitude section. Then important part, the data. It is difficult to solve the whole quantitative aptitude section within 25 minutes. You have 22, 23 minutes for this section in the exam. It is difficult to solve two data interpretation sets and then again solve the arithmetic and algebra and probability. It is very difficult to, you know, out of 35 to solve 25 questions. Very difficult. But what you can do is don't, you know, skip arithmetic part. Very easy. These 12 to 15 questions are very easy, and you can solve this 15 to 16 question within 10 minutes. If you know how to solve them, you can solve that. But whenever you feel difficulty, if you are not comfortable in a specific chapter, you know, there are, I have met many good students also who are not comfortable with, you know, there is a chapter algebra, who are not comfortable with probability. Just skip that part. Except you can divide, if you are going to divide the this quantitative aptitude section, you can divide it into the first part is the data interpretation, the rest one is the algebra, arithmetic, probability. You can combine that part. But during the exam, what I recommend is first do that arithmetic, algebra and probability part. Arithmetic, very important. These small chapters, these very easy chapters, the time and distance, time and work, simple and compound interest, fetch marks from these chapters first. It is, you know, the most of that students who crack the exam follow the strategy. They attempt the data interpretation part after, you know, scoring 12, 15 marks from these easy chapters. After doing that, after spending, you know, like 10 to 12 minutes, you have time for one data interpretation part. one data interpretation set. You can choose from, if there are two sets or three sets, you can choose from the sets. 35 marks are there, 20 are for the arithmetic, and you're trying to score 12 or 13 out of that 20, then it is really very easy, you know, spending 15 minutes or 12 minutes, exactly 12 minutes on these 12, 13 questions, and you are left with 10 minutes. Now you can spend that 10 minutes on data interpretation. That is a kind of insurance. So that is my strategy for quantitative aptitude. You have 23 minutes, do data interpretation after solving the arithmetic questions. Then come to the reasoning part, very important. So the cutoff, the sectional cutoff for quantitative aptitude remain around 6 to 7. The same goes for reasoning, 7 to 8, then again for 6 to 7 for English. You have to score, you know, 7, 8, just assume that you need to score 10 in each section to be on a safe side. Then what about reasoning? In reasoning, you'll find at least one set from sitting arrangement, 5 marks, inequalities. There can be one set from inequality. There is no question from inequalities. One sitting arrangement, 5 marks, then another 5 marks for this inequalities, then machine input output, very common topic. Then you'll find last time in SBI PO exam I saw 2 puzzles. So you can find 2 puzzles. In the puzzles I have made a separate video for blood relation. It is, you know, highly related. These two chapters are highly related. The concept is related. In the puzzle you will see the blood relation mixed up with the, you know, very strange variables. So I'll make a video on this puzzles part. I have also made a workbook. I have made a free workbook on puzzles. You can go to bankexamstoday.com and download that free puzzles ebook, workbook actually. Then the data sufficiency, sometimes there it is the simplest part. You just need to find whether you can solve the question using the given data or not, whether the data is sufficient to solve the questions or not. Very easy part, up to 5 marks from data sufficiency. Then you will find 5 to 10 questions from blood relations, problem based on ages, direction sense test, statement causes assumption analysis. So this is the easiest part of the whole exam, that blood relation, problem based on ages, direction sense test. You will find at least 7 to 8 marks from these 4-5 chapters, and it is the easiest part. The blood relation chapter, I have also already made the video about blood relation, and I'm mentioning that link of the blood relation chapter in the description. Read about, watch that video, and I'll make videos on all these chapters maybe within 2 or 3 weeks. Just go through that whole series of videos. So the data sufficiency part, the blood relation, problem based on ages, direction sense, statements and assumptions, these parts, these chapters are really very easy. You can fetch 10 marks very easily from these chapters. Inequalities is also very easy chapter. I have already shared on bankexamstoday.com about king soldier technique, very easy technique, that shortcut technique. After watching that question, you can solve that within 20 seconds. If there are multivariable question, you can even solve that within 40 seconds, 1 minute, very easy part. So by doing that, you can fetch around 12 to 15 marks even without doing that sitting arrangement and puzzle. After doing that, after spending that 10 to 12 minutes on these chapter, go on with sitting arrangement and puzzle. So if you are allotting 20 to 25 minutes on reasoning ability section, 22 minutes, that's what I recommend, 22 minutes, spend 10 minutes, 10 to 12 minutes on these chapters. After that, you need to pick questions from puzzles and sitting arrangement. You know, you will find three sets in the sitting arrangement and puzzle. It is very difficult to, you know, attempt all these puzzles and sets. For a normal human being, it is difficult to attempt all these sets. So you need to pick. So decide it first, and at the time at the exam you need to decide whether, after just going through the simple going through the whole that section, you will get to know that, yeah, this is a setting arrangement, circular setting arrangement question. And you can say, I am not comfortable with the circular setting arrangement question in which there are people who are sitting inside and outside. That kind of puzzle, a particular student is not comfortable. If you are not comfortable, don't attempt that puzzle. Save your time and go to that another puzzle, right? There are three puzzles right there, two or three. Attempt the another puzzle. Just skip it. If you are not comfortable with the particular type of question, just skip that part. And for the study material, what are the good study material available for the reasoning ability section? So again, the book by R.S. Agarwal, that is a bulky book, you know, 1,200-1,300 pages. That is, you know, outdated book. Don't follow that book. And I'm very sad to say that there are no good books available for the reasoning section. As of now, I have tried a lot of books. I have around 200 books in front of me on my table, on my rack. So I tried all the books and I don't find any book, you know, good enough so that I can recommend to my students. No book is good enough. Even my book, that is a bit strange and bad to say that. In my book, puzzles are good. According to me, I have done, I think, good with puzzles. Actually, I have made separate small ebooks for each section. For the puzzles, I have made a separate ebook, free ebook. For the seating arrangement, I have made a separate ebook, free ebook again. So you can download those ebooks and you can practice puzzles or seating arrangement or inequalities from the practice sets or online test series. You can practice sets from these resources. Don't follow R.S. Agarwal or those kind of books. What I have seen is that students go to Amazon or Flipkart. What they do is they just check out the various reasoning books. There are no good books available. That at the end of the day, they end up buying the R.S. Agarwal, and that's how they ruin their chances of getting selected, getting passing this exam. So don't follow that book at all. So that's all with the reasoning ability. Now the English. So that is the easy, according to me, that is the easiest section for the exam. Out of 30, a reasonably good student can achieve 22-23 easily. 20 plus. It is very easy to score 20 plus from this section. How? Because what I have seen is the most of the students who start their preparation, what they do is they don't they don't read newspapers, and they never read any novels, or they are not used to reading a long chunk of text. So for those people, it is very difficult to at the time of exam reading long paragraphs. They find it a bit boring, so it is very difficult for them to solve a whole paragraph in the exam. So what you should do, start reading a newspaper. It will help you in preparing for the general awareness section during exams. So read a newspaper, read what you love, start reading. It will improve your vocab, it will improve your pronunciation, it will improve your confidence at the time of interview. People that interviews ask questions in English. If you are not good enough in English, I have seen many people who at the time of interview, they say that we want to give interview in Hindi. They are okay with it. The interviews just allow them to give the interview in Hindi, but it makes a bad impression. Even if you are comfortable with Hindi, but English is, it's our official language. In English, in English, actually, all the documents are in English. Even your, application form is in English. So you have to be fluent with the English language. You need to be fluent. Even if you are making grammar mistakes, I too make many grammar mistakes in my videos. But you should be comfortable with English. So in English, let's start without much ado. There are, in the English section, you will find two reading comprehensions, long reading comprehension with the topics you are not comfortable with. Maybe you are expecting that banking or the foreign exchange or foreign policy, but you will find the sets from psychology or medicine or history. You will find such topics, and do not assume the answers at your own. So what you feel. So that is the main problem, main concern that I have. that what students do after reading a paragraph, they start making decision on the behalf of author. You don't need to do that. Just go through the paragraph, and you need to know about what are the various ideas that author wants to, you know, throw in that piece of work, and you need to answer those questions in your exam. So the next part, the synonym, antonyms, and the vocab. You'll find 4 to 5 marks question from this part: synonym, antonyms, and vocab. Easy part, according to me. But many times, what I find is if you don't know the answer, don't, you know, make lame guesses. That is the part where most of the students make lame guesses. Okay, the next part, the synonyms, antonyms, and vocab. So do not make lame guesses at this part, the synonym, antonyms, and vocabs. What I feel is that you are getting a lot of negative marks in this part. If you don't know the answer about a particular question, just leave it blank. No need to, you know, make lame guesses. If you are making lame guesses at the other parts of the exam, reading comprehension, or other parts of exam, you know, you are actually, there is a higher probability of getting correct marks. But if you do not have any clue, if you don't know even anything about the topic, then it's stupid to make a lame guess. Don't make lame guess, make a calculated estimation. That is the best part. That's what most intelligent, most, you know, successful people do in these online exams or these MCQ exams, that they make calculated calculated risk. They know that out of these 5 options, these 2 could be the answer. So you are having a, you know, higher probability of getting a mark. So at the end of the day, you'll get a positive mark. So the next part, the para jumble. Many people find it really very easy. You need to make, you know, after reading those 5 lines, it is time consuming as compared to other parts. It is time consuming. I have seen many people who spend like 10-12 minutes in these 5 questions. At the end of the day, they don't fetch any mark. So it's stupid. So if in the exam, sometimes there are difficult para jumbles, sometimes there are easy para jumbles. So what my strategy is, just find the pairs in that four or five lines, sentences, find the pairs. So after finding the pairs, it will be very easy to, you know, pick the answers from that options. So that's my strategy. You will find 5 questions, para jumbles or sentence rearrangement. Then close test, easiest part, very easy part. Don't skip close test in your exam if you ever see this, the close test. It is simple kind of reading comprehension with the, you know, blanks. It's the easiest part, and they place close test at the end of exam because they want you to skip that part. But do not skip that part. Then spotting grammatical errors. So it is also one of the very easy part. You can read my grammar book that I wrote with the help of some teachers. I didn't write that. You can find that grammar ebook, grammar notes, that is available free of cost from bankexamstoday.com. I will provide the link to the PDF in the comments section, right? So that's all from me about what's good and bad about this exam, the good study material, the bad study material. And what else, you can go to testpanda.com for the online test series. You should take online test series. And if you can't afford that, you can go to bankexamstoday.com. You can download the free model papers that are available. I have provided in English, and I'm going to provide some model papers in Hindi also. Just go through those papers. But I request you to take at least 1 or 2 online exams. So before, you know, going to the exam, you have some, you are comfortable with the screens and those, you know, people from that, some rural areas, who don't have access to internet or, you know, access to desktops or computers. I request all of you, you know, try to go to your nearest coaching institutes. You know, I don't recommend much about coaching institutes, but go to the nearest coaching institute and ask them whether you are providing that online test series at your institute. I don't need any coaching. If you need the coaching, you can go for it. But if you don't need any coaching and you just need that test, you can go to them and just ask, I just need the that online test series. They'll be more than happy to serve you at the normal pricing. Would be somewhat, it will be pricier than the normal test series that we provide on the internet. They'll be charging you around 300, 400 or 500 according to the place a month. So you can pay that 400 or 500 money. That is a bit affordable according to me. Just go for it. That is the best part. I have seen many people who crack these exams. They join many test series at many institutes. What they do is they don't go for the coaching. What they do is at their city, they go to all coaching institutes and they take test series of all that coaching institutes. You know, I mean, they spend are merely around 2000 or 2500, but they score a lot better than the students who take coachings. Maybe they are a bit more experienced, but that's a fact that I wanted to share with you. I have two coaching institutes, one at Ranchi and another one is Dhanbad. But you know, it's bad for the business, but I wanted to share that you should join the test series. That is very important thing. Any other tip from my side is that you should be reading current affairs from day one on your mobile. If you have Android phone, you can install the GK Digest Android application from the Play Store. And if you wanna, you know, just if you don't have access to mobile, I assume that you are having an access. If you are watching this video, I think you have an access to a mobile, and most probably it should be an Android phone. Install the GK Digest Android app. I'm providing the link in the description. That is the important part. And if you want to, you know, you need those shortcut techniques, you need my lectures in the form of video, then you can, you know, get my video lectures DVD from bankexamstoday.com. Go to bankexamstoday.com, order my DVD, and you'll be get this DVD within 4 to 5 days. And that's really, you know, affordable, about I think 500 rupees. So that's all from me. I hope this like this video. If you have any doubt, if you have any concern in your mind, make a comment. So I'll be answering all your comments within 24 hours. I promise that. Subscribe the channel. There is a link subscribe in the here. You can just click subscribe, like this video, and I request you to, you know, share this video on your Facebook profile so that more people watch this video, and it will motivate me to make more videos like this. So that's all for today. Thanks for watching. Bye.